A Quantum Sounds Production.
Power, brothers, and sisters! It's never down, right now! And come back to the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High!
That's right!
We are here to show and prove to you today that to the Lord shall be peace! The information that's in this mouth! Let me get Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 5.
Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 5. Thou shalt also consider in thine heart that which a man transgresseth his son.
Hold on, stop right there. The Most High said, thou shalt consider in thy heart as a man chastises thy son. What?
Thou shalt also consider in thine heart that as a man chastises his son, so the Lord thy God chastises thee.
So y'all wonder why we go through so much stuff. Y'all wonder why we have to burn them up aside. Y'all wonder why we in the present project. Read that again.
Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 5. Thou shalt also consider in thine heart that as a man chastiseth his son, so the Lord thy God chastiseth thee.
The Lord chastised us because we broke his laws, statutes, and commands.
That's right.
He gave us blessings for obedience and curses for disobedience. Read all that.
Verse 6. Therefore, thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God.
Therefore, thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God. Because you wicked Negro broke the law of laws, statutes, and commandments, we went into flame. It's time for y'all to wake up and be and come back to the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High.
Hey, boy!
Again, bro.
Therefore, thou shalt keep the commandments.
It's like, therefore, thou shalt keep the commandments. We know.
Of the Lord thy God.
The Lord thy God. Because you didn't keep the commandments, we went into slavery. Read up.
To walk in his way.
To walk in his way. That's what we're doing, y'all. That is the Most High only dealing with Israel. Give me Psalm 147, 19 and 20. That's proof that the Most High is only dealing with you Negro, you Hispanic, and you Native American.
That's right.
Psalms chapter 147, verse 19. He showeth his word unto Jacob.
Man, the Most High showed his word unto Jacob. Read out.
His statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
He showed his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He can't believe it or not, Negro. You living out a judgment of the Most High right now. The Most High said, if you keep the law, statutes unto Israel, we were going to say, read out, bro.
He hath not done so any nation.
The Most High ain't dealing with the other nation. He only did it to Negro, you Hispanics, and you Native American is.
That's right!
The Most High ain't dealing with no other nation. We know, bro.
And as far as his judgment,
as far as judgments of the Most High go,
they have not done.
Y'all just don't know. They ain't even proof of it. It's a God. Because nobody else knows the judgment of the Most High. Let me get up. That the Most High only dealing with you Negroes.
Amos chapter 3 verse 2. You only have I known of all the families of the earth.
The Most High said, you only have I known of all the families of the earth.
Amos chapter 3 verse 1. Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you.
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you. You so-called Native Americans and you so-called Hispanics, hear the word that the Most High spoke against you. Read on, bruh.
O children of Israel.
O children of Israel, because y'all the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. It's time for y'all to wake up and repent.
That's right.
Back to the Most High God.
That's right. Against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt.
Against the whole family which the Most High brought up out of Egypt.
Say, you only have I known.
The Most High only know you so-called Negro. He only know the Israelites. He's only dealing with Israel.
You only have I known of all the families of the earth.
Now kill the true sons of God. Give me 1 Sam 3:1. We the true sons of God. It's time for y'all to wake up. Repent.
1 John 3:1. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us.
Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us.
Read on. That we should be called the sons of God.
Yes, we should be called the sons of God. Because you Negroes are the true sons of God. The white man ain't the son of God. The Arab man ain't the son of God. The Moabites or the Chinese ain't the son of God. It's time for y'all to wake up. Read that from the top again, bro.
1 John 3:1. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us.
It said, behold, what manner of love that the Father bestowed upon us. Because if you read Deuteronomy 7:6, the Most High only loves Israel.
Read on. That we should be called the sons of God.
We are called the sons of God, not the whole world. You Negroes are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. You are the sons of God. That's right, we know, bro.
Therefore, the world doesn't
know. The world doesn't know that we the sons of God. Because we're doing wickedness against the Most High God. So the world don't know that we the sons of God.
We know because it knew him not.
Because it don't know the Most High. Because the Most High said, he that knoweth me and say, you, he that knoweth me and keep not my commandments is a liar. Now hold on, then keep going, bro.
Verse 2, beloved, know we are the sons of God.
So we the sons of God. Now let's see when we became the sons of God. Go to Romans 9:4. Let's see how we became the sons of God. It's time for you Negroes, you Native American Indians, and you Hispanics to wake up.
Romans 9:4. Who are Israelites?
So who are the Israelites?
To who pertaineth the adoption?
Oh, the Israelites pertain to adoption. Give me Galatians 4:4. Let's see how we got this adoption. The Israelites pertain to adoption. We the true sons of God. Because it said the Israelites pertain to adoption. Galatians 4:4.
Galatians 4:4. But when the fullness of the time was come.
So when the fullness of the time had come for Christ to die, we know
God sent for his son.
We know
made of a woman.
Made of a woman.
Made
of Christ. It ain't no such thing as no immaculate conception. We know
made under the law.
Made under the law. According to Leviticus 15. A man and a woman having sex. So Christ didn't come through no immaculate conception. We know.
That's right.
To redeem them that were under the law.
To redeem them that was under the law. Because if we read Psalm 78:5, the Israelites were under the law. You so-called Negro are under the law. You Hispanics are under the law.
That's right.
You Native Americans are under the law.
That's right.
Read that 7:5.
Verse 5. To redeem them that were under the law.
We know.
That we might receive the adoption.
Receive the what?
The adoption.
Receive what?
The adoption.
Receive the adoption. That's what?
Of son.
Of son. So we are true sons of God. It's time for y'all to wake up. Repent. Come back to these laws.
That's right, man.
That's how we wake up. We are true sons of God.
Verse 16. Nevertheless, the Lord raised up judges, which delivered them out of the hand of those that spoke.
Right there, it says the Lord raised up judges to deliver the Israelites out of the hands of those that spoke them.
Yes.
Who robbed us? Who raped us? Who the Lord raised up judges now, because according to Corinthians, the Lord said, the saints shall judge the world. According to Psalm 1:8:14, the Israelites
are the same. Yet, they were not hearkening unto their
judges. They were hearkening unto the judges. We have to bring the you would not talk to the judge. We know, bro.
But they went a hard after other guys.
But y'all went a hard after other guys. Y'all went just like that. You celebrate the God of Easter. You celebrate the God of Christmas. You celebrate the God of Thanksgiving. You celebrate the Halloween. You celebrate birthday. You gotta honor yourself, but you won't go after God. We know.
And bow themselves unto them.
And yo, bow yourself to them.
Teach me that way, O Lord.
Teach me that way, O Lord.
And lead me in a plain path.
And lead me in a plain path.
Because
show me the right way. Show me a simple way. It's simple to keep these laws, statutes, and commandments.
That's right.
On 2 Andrew 7:21 say, the Most High gave us straight commandments to do the Lord's punishment and to live. Read on, bro.
Because of mine enemies, deliver me not over unto the
world. Right there. He said, because they're enemies. Because our enemies look down on us. Go to 1 Peter 5:8. Let's show you what your enemies are trying to do. Because the white man is the so-called devil that the Bible speaks of. Only the other man is the devil that the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
1 Peter 2:8.
5:8.
1 Peter 5:8. Be sober. Be vigilant.
The Moses said, be sober. Be vigilant. Stand up on your feet. Be sober. Forget Gush. Forget that cocaine. Forget that crack. Forget beer. The Most I said, be sober. Be vigilant. Read on, bro.
Because your adversary, the devil.
Your adversary, the devil. Read on.
Is a roaring lion.
He's walking around like a roaring lion now. Ready to take you Negroes out.
Walking about, seeking whom he may devour.
He walking about, seeing whom he may devour. Which one of the Israelites he gonna take out? Go to Revelation 12:12. We gonna show you walking why he walking around, seeing who he gonna defile. It's time for y'all to wake up.
Revelation 12:12. Therefore rejoice ye heavens and ye that dwell in them.
So we say rejoice ye heavens and ye that dwell in them. We know.
Woe to the inhabitants of the earth.
It said woe to the inhabitants of the earth. Cause y'all think when Christ comes back, he gonna be getting out kisses and hugs. The hand of the Lord is a day of destruction. Read on, bro.
Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea.
Read.
For the devil is come down unto you.
Read.
Having great wrath.
Having great wrath. Cause this white man got great wrath on his back. He got great wrath in our neighborhood. He pumped our neighborhood with drugs. He pumped our neighborhood with crack. He pumped our neighborhood with cocaine. He pumped our neighborhood with heroin. He take the borders out of the household. The black family has been destroyed. We know.
Because he knoweth that he has but a short time.
He know he got a short time. You see all these attacks that's happening against him? He know he got a short time.
Yes.
He knew his time almost over. So he trying to see how many of you Israelites he can take with him. That's what he's trying to do. Now let's show you the way that you should walk in. Isaiah 30:21. Let's see the way that you should walk in. Cause y'all the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. You Negroes need to repent.
Isaiah chapter 30, verse 1.
21.
Yeah. Let's show y'all Negroes the way that you should walk in.
Verse 21. And thine ears shall hear a word behind thee.
It says your ears to hear a word behind thee. You hear the word now. As you walk into the stone, you hear the word now behind thee. Read on.
Say.
Say it what?
This is the way. Walk ye in.
This is the way. Walk you in. Walk out of these laws, statutes, and commandments. Let's see some of these laws that our people are not walking in it. Give me Leviticus 19, 17, and 18. Let's get some of the way. This is the way walk you in. We're going to show you the way that you should walk in.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
The Most High said, thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart.
That's
why you Negroes hate each other. Read on.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
You're supposed to correct your neighbor. You're supposed to correct your brother. You're supposed to hate your brother. Right now, people hate that stuff you read about. Read on, bro.
And not suffer sin upon
and
him.
And not suffer sin upon him. What is sin? According to 1 John 3 and 4, sin is the transgression of God's law. Sin is the breaking of God's law. Read on, bro.
Verse 18. Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
So this is the way that you should walk in. Never hate that brother. Never bend or bear any grudge against the children of thy people. This is the way that you should walk in. Read on.
But thou shalt love thy neighbor.
You're supposed to love your brother. You're supposed to love your Israelite brother and sister. But we hate each other. What come we to all the people on the planet of that hate each other? This is the way. Walk in. Read on.
But thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Come to Leviticus 19 and 11. This is the way, walk ye in it. We're going to give you the way, walk ye in it. Read on.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 11. Ye shall not steal, neither deal falsely, neither lie one to another.
So this is another law that you Negroes break. Y'all say y'all want the way. Y'all pray that the Most High show you a better way. Read that again.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 11. Ye shall not steal, neither deal falsely.
You should steal or deal falsely with your brother. You should hate your brother.
That's why
you hold your brother against your brother. We know.
Neither lie one to another.
Or lie one to another. Because the Lord said in 1 Corinthians 3 and 9, a liar shall not inherit the kingdom of heaven. Let me get on. Leviticus 18 and 22. We've been showing you the way that you should walk in. This is the way, walk ye in it. Read, bruh.
Leviticus chapter 18, verse 22. Thou shalt not lie with mankind.
So Moses said, don't lie with mankind. What?
As with womankind.
As with womankind. This is the way, walk ye in it. And we got a whole lot of undercover homo in the neighborhood. This is the way, walk ye in it. Go from there to Leviticus 11, verse 45. We saw y'all the way that you should walk in it. Because we weren't walking in any way. Because we weren't walking after the ways of the Most High. Our people went into slavery. So if y'all wake up, read
Leviticus chapter 11, verse 45. For I am the Lord that bringeth you up out of the land of Egypt.
Most I say, he brought us up out of the land of Egypt. And the second time, he gonna recover us from this place. Read on, bruh.
To be your God.
To be our God. Because according to Deuteronomy 4 and 19, the Most High ain't everybody God. He gave them the sun, the moons, and the stars to work.
That's
why I got it earned through him. Read on.
Ye shall therefore be holy.
We shall therefore be holy. But we ain't no holy people no more. We defiled in the streets of America. Read on, bruh.
For I am holy.
The Most High said, he is holy. He is holy. Read on.
There is the law of beasts.
That is the law of beasts right here. This is the way. Walk ye in it. Read on.
This is the law of beasts and of the fowl and of every living creature that moveth in the water.
So the Most High gave us clean and unclean food to eat. But what do the Negroes do? Y'all look around the laws of God and do whatever you feel that your heart wants to do. Read on.
And of the fowl, and of every living creature that moveth in the water, and of every creature that
difference.
The Most High said to make a difference
between the unclean
and between the unclean
and the clean.
So this the way funky is. But you know what? The preacher in the church had a first team in for a vote. Get first team in for a vote. All the way down the back. Get first team in for a vote. The Lord said to make a difference between clean and unclean meat. So this is the way funky is. We are
1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 4.
That's how preacher loves this verse right here.
For every creature of God is good.
Oh, every creature of God is good. Oh, what is good? Hold on, stop right there. Because we command to read the Bible. Precept upon precept. Land upon land. Little, little, done, little. Isaiah 3:18. This a preacher tell you that. We are Romans 7 and 12.
Romans chapter 7, verse 12. Wherefore, the law is holy.
The law is good. The law is holy. So that you can eat clean and unclean food, we know.
And the commandment holy.
And the commandments is holy.
And just and good.
So the commandments is just is good. Go back to where you was at. So that you can eat clean and unclean food. The Most High said, he put a difference between the clean and unclean. So you let your preacher tell you something else. Read, brother.
1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 4. For every creature of God is good. And nothing to be refused if it be received with thanksgiving.
So every creature of God is good if he keeps his law. Whatever he told you that was made clean is good. Read on, bro.
Verse 5. For it is sanctified by the word of God.
So what it means to be sanctified by the word of God? Give me John 17:17. What it mean to be sanctified to God? Now we try to bring out these laws to you so-called Negroes. But to the Israelite that the Bible speaks of.
Yes, right.
John, the Lord said, be ye so. That's how we do it, smoke weed, smoke kush, drink beer, pop pills, sip syrup. The Lord said, be sober and vigilant. Read on, bro.
John chapter 17, verse 17. Sanctify them through thy truth.
The Most High said, sanctify them through thy truth. Psalm 119, verse 142 say, thy law is truth. Read on.
Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth.
The Most High said, thy word is truth. Read on. Y'all see that on that, 17:17?
Yeah.
1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 5. For it is sanctified by the word of God.
So it's sanctified by the word of God. The Most High said, he gave us clean and unclean food. It's time for y'all to wake up and return back to the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High.
That's
repent.
Right.
You are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
Who is this?
See, that's the problem with you blacks and Hispanics. Y'all don't want to hear the law of the Lord. We out here trying to teach y'all the law, but y'all rather shuck and jive and coon. But, see, the problem is that y'all don't want to keep the commandments because y'all's pastors and y'all slave masters has told y'all that the law is done away with. But the law has never been destroyed. The law is here to stay, and you must keep the commandments of the Most High God. Give me 2 Andrews 9 and 12. 2 Andrews 9 and 37. So you, the law ain't went nowhere. So your pastors have been lying to you from the start. You must keep the commandments, and you the Israelites the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
So-called blacks and Hispanics. Read.
2 Exodus chapter 9, verse 37. Notwithstanding the law. 2 Exodus chapter 9, verse 37.
Read.
Notwithstanding the law perisheth not.
Notwithstanding the law perishes not. So the law ain't went nowhere. Y'all just been lied to in the sea. We gonna see what Christ said. Go to Matthew 5:17. Cause the law ain't went nowhere. Y'all been deceived and lied to for many, many years. Y'all gonna learn today that you the Israelites that God speaks of. That you must keep God's commandments or die here in America.
I am not come to destroy,
but to fulfill.
And that's where y'all get dumb and simple. Y'all think Christ came to fulfill the law, so we don't have to do it no more. Let's see what Christ came to fulfill. Hold that, give me Luke 24:44. Let's see what Christ came to fulfill, because y'all think Christ came to fulfill the law. And y'all don't have to keep the law no more. He fulfilled the law in himself, so I'm good. Well, let's see what the Bible says. Read.
Luke chapter 24, verse 44. And he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you.
These are the words that I spake unto you, read.
While I was yet with you.
While I was yet with you, Christ, while Christ was speaking to the disciples, he said, these are the words that I speak unto you while I was yet with you.
Read. That all things must be fulfilled.
That all things must be fulfilled. Read.
Which were written in the law of the of Moses.
Read.
And in the prophets.
Read.
And in Psalms.
Read.
Concerning me.
Concerning Christ. That's what Christ came to fulfill. He came to fulfill all that was written about him in the law and in the Psalms. From the get-go, thinking the law is done away with. Why? To keep you in sin. That's the reason.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 17. Think not that I come to destroy the law.
I said, think not that I come to destroy the law. Read.
Or the prophets.
Or the prophets.
I have come not to destroy, but to fulfill.
Not to destroy, but to fulfill. Fulfill everything written in him. Jump down to verse 19.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 19. Whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments.
Christ is saying, whosoever shall break one of these least commandments. Because y'all might think growing a beard, having fringes on your garments, having your head covered is a least commandment. But it's you must keep all God's commandments.
That's right. And shall teach men so.
And shall teach men so. But you don't teach just by words, you teach by example.
He shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven.
He shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. So what was that talk about? That means you get in the kingdom of heaven? No! Ain't no such thing as no least king. Hold that book, Isaiah. Let's see what Christ is talking about. He that shall break one of these least commandments shall be called least in the kingdom. Because it's high time you blacks and Hispanics wake up to the truth of the Bible.
Isaiah chapter 66, verse 24.
Read.
And they shall go forth and look upon the carcasses of men that have transgressed against me.
So the Israelites, those who keep God's commandments, shall go forth and look upon the dead carcasses of all those who transgress the laws of the Most High God. Meaning women wearing pants, men shaving their face off, disobeying the Sabbath. Today is the Lord's Sabbath day, but yet y'all buying and saying, yes, women are not supposed to wear pants, sister. Women are not supposed to wear pants. Matter of fact, give me that in Deuteronomy 22:5. I'm going to show you, so you're going to drive up. I'm going to show you. Edification thing. Hold that. Give me Deuteronomy 22:5. Sister, you are not supposed to wear pants. I'm going to talk to you about your slave master, the so-called white man. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5.
Read.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto man.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. Read.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So a man is not supposed to put on a woman's garment. What's a woman's garment? What's a woman's garment? A dress. Thank you. Read the first side. Read the first verse. Read it from the top again. So if a woman's garment is a dress, read.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So if a woman's garment is a dress, what do women wear that pertains to men? Pants. That's against me. And Christ said, I come not to destroy the law or the prophets, but I come to fulfill everything written of him. So you must keep these commandments. Women are not supposed to be wearing pants, just like men are not supposed to shave their beards. Give me that in Leviticus 22:5. We're going to get into some of these commandments that y'all breaking, thinking that the Most High is done away with the law. Because the Christian church has told you for many years that the law is done away with. Read.
Leviticus chapter 21, verse 5.
Read.
They shall not make baldness upon their head.
So you're not supposed to bald your head, meaning shave your head bald like Michael Jordan. Read.
Neither shall they shave off the corners of their beard.
Neither shall you shave off the corners of your beard. Meaning you're not supposed to shave. However your beard grows, you're not supposed to cut into it. You're not supposed to shave it off. And that smooth baby face. So if you love God, you're going to do what God said. Y'all love God? You love God? You're going to do what the Bible says. If you do, if you don't, you're going to die in America.
That's right.
Give me back 5 cents. Back to the laws is not done away with. These basic laws, these commandments that you're not keeping, you're going to be destroyed when Christ returns.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 19. And whosoever therefore shall break one of these, whosoever shall break one of these least commandments.
So whosoever shall break one of these least commandments, like the commandments we just brought out, women in pants, men wearing dresses, shaving your beard off.
Read. And shall teach men so.
And shall teach men so. Because you don't only teach with your mouth, you teach by example.
That's read. Right. He shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven.
Meaning death. Read.
But whosoever shall do and teach them.
But whosoever shall do and teach them. Meaning you got your pants above your waist. You're keeping the commandments of the Most High God. You're obeying the Sabbath. You got a beard on your face. And you're teaching men so to do, like we're out here doing today. Read.
And the same shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven.
Those that keep the commandments when Christ returns shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. And like the brother brought out, it's only for the Israelites. Read on down.
Verse 20. For I say unto you, that except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees.
So it said, except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees. Because the scribes and Pharisees, they was keeping some of the law, they weren't keeping some of the law, and they was making up the law. So let's see what righteousness is. Hold that. Give me Deuteronomy 6:25. Deuteronomy 6:25. Let's see what righteousness is. Since he said, if your righteousness doesn't exceed the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees.
Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 25. And it shall be our righteousness if we observe to do all these commandments.
So it shall be our righteousness if we observe to do what?
All these commandments.
Read.
Before the Lord our God.
Read.
As he hath commanded us.
As he has commanded us. Go back to Matthew. So you must keep the commandments of the Most High.
That's right.
Read it from the top, verse 20.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 20. For I say unto you, that except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees.
So except your keeping of the law shall not exceed the keeping of the law of the scribes and Pharisees. Do what?
Ye shall in no case enter into the heaven, kingdom of heaven.
So if you're not keeping all the words in this Bible, you're not making it into the kingdom of heaven. I don't care how mighty and holy and how valued you think you are. I don't care how much you think you have a relationship with God. You're not keeping the commandments of the Bible.
So a lot of y'all want to know, how do we know that we are the Israelites according to the Bible? Because our brothers out here have been telling you that you blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans are the Israelites in the Bible.
That's right.
Our history is in this Bible. We have to read this Bible in order to understand where we come from.
That's right.
So let me get Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. Let's start in verse 1.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So God said, if you will hearken unto his voice diligently, read on.
And do all his commandments.
And do all his commandments.
Which I command you this day. That the Lord thy God will give you. And the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
So God said if we keep these commandments, then we would be set on high above all people that's on this earth. But we didn't choose to do that. We chose to go another route. Let's get Deuteronomy 28:15.
How you doing, sister? All praises, sister.
Deuteronomy chapter 28:15. It's like I said, we decided to go the faithful route. We chose not to keep God's laws and commandments. So since we chose not to keep His laws and commandments, these are the curses that came upon us. This is how you know who the so-called Israelites are in the Bible.
That's right.
This is how you know who the black Latinos and Native Americans are today. Verse 15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28:15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all His commandments, and His statutes, which I command thee this day.
So he says, since you, if you won't keep my commandments that I have commanded you this day, read.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. So what are these curses that came upon us and overtook us? 15 through 68, Deuteronomy 28, chapter 28, 15 through 68 is all the curses. But we just gonna go over a few. Let's get verse 32.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people. Who did that happen to in history? When you read, the blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, our sons and our daughters were given unto another people, unto another nation. Read on.
And thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long, and there shall be no might in thine hand.
There was no might. There was no might in our hand to get our people back. Our children were taken away from us, and we had no might in our hand to get our people back. Go to verse 41, because it says the same thing.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 41. Thou shalt beget sons and daughters, but thou shalt not enjoy them, for they shall go into captivity.
Because they will go into captivity. When we had our sons and our daughters, they went right into captivity just like us. We lost lots of our sons and our daughters. As soon as we had them, they were sold to other plantations. That only happened to one nation of people, the Israelites in the Bible, the so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans today. Give me verse 45. Because we have to see what these curses are and what they are to recognize who the blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans are today.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee, and shall pursue thee, and overtake thee, till thou be destroyed.
So he said these curses shall come upon us and overtake us, until we be destroyed. Read on.
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to keep His commandments and His statutes, which I command thee. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
And it said, and they, still talking about these curses, and they shall be upon thee, read on,
for a sign and a wonder.
For a sign. What is a sign? That sign right there says Philip 66. So we know this is Philip 66. This sign right there says Lodi Avenue. So we know this is Lodi Avenue. So when we read these curses in the Bible, they are signs to let you know that these blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans are the real Israelites in the Bible. We know.
And upon thy seed forever.
Upon thy seed forever. This was written about 3,500 years ago. This is still forever. These curses is still a sign upon our people. Read.
Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart and for the abundance of all things.
Because we chose not to serve the Lord our God. Jump down to verse 48.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 48. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
So it said, thou therefore shalt thy serve thine enemies. Thy enemies. Read on.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
Which the Lord shall send against thee. Yes, these other nations had us in captivity, which the Bible calls them our enemies. Yes, they had us in captivity, but God sent them upon us because we chose not to keep His laws and His commandments. Read on.
And hunger.
And in hunger. So if you want food, you got to go to these other nations for food. You don't own the grocery stores. You don't own Price Chopper's. You don't own any of these farmlands, so you gotta go to the other nations for food. We don't.
And in thirst.
And in thirst. We don't own any beaches. We don't own the pipelines. We don't own Aquafina or Dasani. If you want water, you gotta go to these other nations. Rito.
And in nakedness.
And in nakedness. We don't own none of the raw textiles. We don't own none of the JCPenney's, the Macy's. We don't own any of that. If you want clothes, you gotta go to these other nations. Read.
And in want of all things.
And in want of all things. If you want a job, if you want a car, if you want a house, if you want education, where you gotta go to? We own none of the schools. We don't own our businesses. We gotta go to the other nations for everything. Read on.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck. Who put yokes of iron upon us in captivity? It was the so-called whites, the Arabs, the Africans. That's who put those yokes of iron upon us. Only the blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans had yokes of iron upon their necks in captivity.
Until he has destroyed thee.
Until he has destroyed us. Not physically, but mentally. You gon' keep that yoke of iron on your neck until you say your name is Toph. You gon' keep that yoke of iron on your neck until you stop speaking Hebrew and speak English. Forget everything that you knew. Jump to verse 68. So now, this is a verse to let you know how we got here. Deuteronomy 28, verse 68.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. With ships.
So it said, the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. They went into Egypt the first time and came to Egypt and then walked over and walked out. Let's see what Egypt means. Give me Exodus 22. Let's see what Egypt means. Because Egypt is a Greek word for bondage or captivity. So he said he will bring thee into Egypt again with ships. What is Egypt?
Exodus. Verse 2, I am the Lord thy God, which I brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
Out of the house of bondage. Egypt is synonymous with the house of bondage. Let's go back to verse 68.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
So he shall bring us into captivity again with ships. Who has a nation of people went into captivity on cargo slave ships? That didn't happen to everybody. It only happened to the blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. We the only people that went into captivity on cargo slave ships.
By the way thereof, I speak unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
We shall never see our homeland again. We've never been back to Jerusalem. Read on.
And there he shall be sold unto your enemies.
Again, we shall be sold unto our enemies,
for bond men and bond women.
For slave men and slave women. So again, it said these are our enemies. Why do y'all want to be friends with these people? Y'all think y'all equal to the white man or the Arab man? We not equal to them. We above all of them. We do the Deuteronomy 7:6. Because God said the Israelites, the so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, we're above all people upon the face of the earth.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God.
The Israelites, thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth. So why do y'all want to be friends with the people that God said were your enemies? Why do you want to be friends with them? Why do you want to be equal with them? Why do you think you're on the same level with them? God never created us equal to them. Let me get Deuteronomy 32. Because God separated all these other nations according to his people. All these other nations are nothing, but you chose to put yourself in that position. This whole world was made for us, but you chose to live by what the white man told you.
Yes.
Read on.
The Most High divided the nations.
So when the Most High divided the nations, read on. only set the bounds of the people according to the number of Israel, his chosen people, the so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. So again, like I said, we are equal to these people. Let me get 2 Ezra chapter 6, verse 54. We weren't equal to these people, but yet you want to be equal to your enemy.
That's right.
The Bible says these nations are nothing. And since we chose not to keep his commandments, we will be brought down to nothing as well. Read.
2 Ezra chapter 6, verse 54. And after these, Adam also, who thou madest Lord of all thy creatures, of him come we all.
So it says that Adam, we come all from Adam. All these people upon this earth, we all come from Adam. But read on.
And the people also whom thou hast chosen.
And the people also whom thou hast chosen. Like we read in Deuteronomy 7 and 6. He chose the Israelites, you blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. Read on.
All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sake.
He made the world for our sakes. So why are you ignorant blacks and Latinos fighting over a block? Why do you want to walk around with your pants hanging below your butt? Why do you want to continue to destroy your people with drugs? Want to be whores, thieves, robbers? Read on. He said he made the world for our sakes. Read on.
As for the other people.
As for the other people. Let's see what God said about the other people that aren't blacks, the so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans.
Which also come from Adam.
Because these people also come of Adam. Read on.
Thou hast said that they are nothing.
Nothing. They are nothing. Read on. Right.
But be right. Like unto spittle.
Like unto spittle. Spit. You don't care about spit. The same way God don't care about these other nations. That's why y'all in the positions y'all in. Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. That's why y'all the last hired, first fired. That's why we populate the ghettos. That's why we have the highest rate in STDs, diseases, all of that. Read on.
And has likened the abundance of them unto the drop that falleth from a vessel.
So like we got a big bucket of water. You drop a little bit out, you don't care. But you have to realize that you blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans are above anybody else upon this planet. And come back to God's laws, statutes, and commandments. That's the only way you're going to get the kingdom. Otherwise, you'll just be destroyed. Everybody else will be destroyed. If you don't want to keep these commandments, you won't be part of that two-thirds. So this is what's going to happen to you if you choose not to keep God's laws and commandments.
Zechariah chapter 13, verse 8. And it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith the Lord, two parts the head shall be cut off,
so die. So two parts shall be cut off and die. If you choose not to keep God's laws and commandments, you will not.
Hey, y'all.
Read on.
What? What? The third shall be left therein.
So the one third that will keep God's laws and commandments, to not buy yourself on the Sabbath day, to keep all his holy days, to keep these laws and commandments, to keep them there, to not eat any of these unclean foods. What will happen? Jesus, read on.
As he sat
as he sat at meat. But when the disciples saw it, they had indignation, saying, "To what purpose is this waste? For this ointment might have been sold for much and given to the poor."
So the disciples thought that this was a waste, but let's see what Jesus said.
When Jesus understood it, he said unto them, "Why trouble ye the woman? For she hath brought a good work upon me. For ye have the poor always with you, but me ye have not always. For in that she hath poured this ointment on my body, she did it for my burial."
So we're doing this for Christ's burial. Read on.
"Verily I say unto you, wheresoever this gospel shall be preached in the whole world, there shall also this that this woman hath done be told for a memorial of her."
So when we coming out telling you blessings,